In line with the directives of Speaker Martin Romualdez, our leader here in Congress, na i-amend ang RTL upang siguraduhin na mapababa po natin ang presyo ng bigas para sa mamamayang Pilipino.
Ang problema kasi, kaya tumataas ang presyo ng bigas dahil ang mga trader ay nagko-compete. Pataasan sila ng presyuhan sa pagbili ng palay at wala tayong control doon. Kung magkaroon ng mga amendments sa NFA at sa rice tarification, sa NFA charter at saka sa rice tarification law, magagawa natin, makokontrol natin.
Good morning po mga congressmen. First question po kay Congressman Jill Bonggalon. Any update po dun sa ethics complaint versus sa former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez? Nakapag-submit na rin po ba siya ng reply dun sa notice po ng committee?
Right, thank you for that question. Again, good morning. As an update, we had a committee meeting, the Committee on Ethics and Privileges last Thursday afternoon, wherein we had an initial consideration of the claim of the complaint filed by Ray T. Oy of Tagum City and accompanied by several complainants against former Speaker and First District Representative of Davao del Norte, Congressman Pantaleon Alvarez. So basically, the complaint alleges three violations of the Code of Conduct, that amounts to disorderly behavior as a public official, conduct unbecoming, as well as violation of the libel provision and sedition and inciting to sedition of the provisions of the revised penal code. So, number one, of course, the libelous remarks made by Congressman Alvarez against his co-officials from Davao del Norte. These are libelous in the sense that these are very dangerous remarks, no, towards a co-public official. Number two, of course, the allegation of habitual absences, no, in Congress. Hindi po nakikita, base po dun sa complaint, dito po sa Kongreso si Congressman Alvarez. Pangatlo, yung kanya pong statement, no, seditious utterances and statements during a public rally in Davao, wherein he is calling for the withdrawal of support of the Armed Forces of the Philippines as well as the Philippine National Police to withdraw their support to the administrations. No? So, again, as mentioned, we had an initial consideration, and when we speak of initial consideration of the complaint, we are looking to the determination of whether the complaint is sufficient in form and content. And as found out by the committee, the complaint filed by Ray Uy is sufficient in form and in content. And that is why the committee decided to send a notice to the office of Congressman Alvarez for him to answer these allegations within 10 days from receipt. And upon update of the committee secretary, the notice was able to has been sent, no, to the office of Congressman Alvarez through registered mail, mm-hmm, last Friday, and also via electronic copy through the registered and official email address of Congressman Alvarez as well as his chief of staff. So right now, wala pa ho tayong natatanggap ang committee na sagot from Congressman Alvarez. And anyway, we are giving him 10 days from receipt within which to file his answer or reply to the allegations.
Congressman, ano po ba yung trajectory natin dito? Kasi hanggang May 24 lang po yung session, di ba, ng Kamara. Ito po ba tututukan to ng Ethics Committee? Ano po yung plano?
Well, as explained earlier, the allegations are very serious in such a way that the committee has to act on it. No, so we have to wait until the lapse of the 10 days, whether or not there is a reply or answer from Congressman Alvarez. The committee is set to call a committee hearing, and we will also call the complainants to explain themselves about the allegations being heard against Congressman Alvarez. So basically, the timeline would be there will be a committee hearing, no, any day of next week, so after the lapse of 10 days.
Thank you po. Second question pa for everyone. Pwede pong sumagot. Kanina po sa isang ambush interview kay President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., he said po, he will certify as urgent bill yung amendments po sa RICE tarification law. Your reaction lang po. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Napakaganda po ng development na kanina nabasa ko rin yun at sinabi ng ating Pangulo na sinesertify niya as urgent yung amendments para sa RICE tarification law. This is in line with the directives of Speaker Martin Romualdez, our leader here in Congress, na i-amend ang RTL upang siguraduhin na mapababa po natin ang presyo ng bigas para sa mamamayang Pilipino. Ramdam po natin na isa sa mga pangunahing hamon na hinaharap na ating mga kababayan ay yung patuloy na pagtaas ng presyo ng bilihin. And amending the RICE tarification law is one sure step that we can have more competitive prices for Filipinos. Right now, ongoing po yung committee hearing ng Committee on Agriculture headed by Congressman Mark Inverga. And I do hope that the Senate can begin their hearings for the RICE tarification law, given that we will be going on sine die break within 3 weeks. So medyo pressed for time po tayo, but dahil may urgency na pong ang binitawan ang ating mahal na Pangulo, so makakaasa po ang ating mga mamamayan na hindi po matutulog ang mababang kapulungan sa isyung ito, at may papasa po namin ito bago po kami mapunta sa break.
To add lang kay Kong JJ, I was there kanina kasi I'm a member of the committee. So the secretary was there, Secretary Laurel, and he gave us also an opening statement kung how they will treat the urgency and of course how will they treat the RICE tarification law amendment. May isa lang akong nadampot mula dun sa speech niya, which is tingin ko very important. It's an element not contained in the policy, but an element of something that is crucial to the amendment also, na they were monitoring pala yung weather. Since nasa fishing industry po si Secretary Laurel, parang key point nung part nung speech niya was every 15 years daw po nagkaka-El Nino. Pero as we went on further, parang nagiging every 3 to 5 years na. So nagkakaroon na ng frequency. So even the supply, even the demand will be affected, even yung production will be affected. So maganda rin na kinonsider yung mga points ni Secretary, not only in terms of policy, not only in terms of economics, but also in terms of the environment as well, the changing climate. Thank you.
Ben, question.
Mr. President, good morning.
Good morning.
Nais po ng Kongreso na amyendahan ng RICE tarification law to allow the NFA to sell cheap rice in the markets. Will you support this initiative and will you certify it as urgent?
Yes, it is something that has come up. That we are so that the ang problema kasi kaya tumataas ang presyo ng bigas dahil ang mga trader ay nagko-compete. Pataasan sila ng presyuhan sa pagbili ng palay at wala tayong control doon. Kung magkaroon ng mga amendments sa NFA at sa RICE tarification, sa NFA charter at saka sa RICE tarification law, magagawa natin, makokontrol natin, meron tayong influence dun sa presyuhan, sa pagbili ng palay at sa pagbenta ng bigas. So that's what we are going to do.
Will you certify the bill as urgent, sir?
Yes, I think it justifies an urgent certification. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next question, Tuesday.
Good morning, Mr. President.
There you are.
Sabi po ng Department of Education na isubmit na raw po sa office po ninyo yung recommendation para sa mga panukalang ibalik yung calendar, school calendar, gawin na pong June ulit yung pasukan as soon as possible. Ano po ang tugon niyo po dito? Oh?
Well, of course, hiningi ko yan sa DepEd and I ask Inday Sara to give me already a concrete plan because mukha naman, hindi na tayo kailangan mag-antay pa. At mukha naman, kailangan na. At I don't see any objections really from anyone. especially with the El Nino being what it is. Every day, you turn on the news, F2F classes are canceled, F2F classes have been postponed, etc. So talagang kailangan ng kailangan na. So yes, that's part of the plan that we are trying to do to bring it back already to the old schedule. Yeah, I think it will be better for the kids.
Will this be implemented by next year na, sir?
Hopefully. Hopefully by next year, yes. By next year, matatapos na.
Next question, Maricel Halili.
Hi, sir. Magandang umaga. Sir, may mga panukala po na lagyan na ng water cannon yung mga vessel natin na pumapalaot. Will you give the go signal on that, sir?
No. What we are doing is defending our sovereign rights and our sovereignty in the West Philippine Sea. And we have no intention of attacking anyone with water cannons or any other such offensive, I would have to call them weapons, dahil nakaka-damage na. So no, that is not something that's in the plan. The last thing we would like was to raise the tensions in the West Philippine Sea. That's the last thing, and that will certainly do that. So hindi natin gagawin. We will not follow the Chinese Coast Guard and the Chinese vessels down that road because it's simply it is not the mission of our Navy, our Coast Guard, to start or to increase tensions. Their mission is precisely the opposite, is to lower tensions. And that's right. So that's why hindi tayo, wala tayo. All we do is pagka nangyayari, we know water cannon yung mga barko natin, ay nagpapadala tayo ng demarche, nagpapadala tayo ng sulat sa China and the other stakeholders. So that would be the opposite of what we are trying to achieve, would be to put any kind of cannon on our ships.
Thank you.
All right. Sige, salamat.